Hey, so when I was a kid, I was pale and skinny, so kids called me a ghost, and later I decided writing is more than just a fun hobby. I'm Ghostwriter, and this is why I care so much about Lion, the 2016 film that I just think is awesome. Yeah, so in my last video, I talked about how in Star Trek Discovery, the characters kind of suck, so now I'm going to talk about characters I actually think, or a character that I actually think is really great. There are specific film techniques that build the real-life, real-world story of Lion that make us understand and care about it so much. Editing and stakes. The film employs a method of cutting that follows throughout the entire film, cutting in front and behind of Saru, the main character, many times, creating motion in the progression of his story arc. This happens over and over in most scenes, exploring this dangerous environment, with the protagonist almost always centered in the frame. This method of editing delivers the experience that this child is going through. He is always moving, running away from bad people in hopes of running towards good people, or his family. Let me show you a scene I've re-edited to take away this method. We'll have a number of jump cuts. Now, let's watch how they did it. Much better, right? We know what's before him and what's after him, where he's going and where he's been. In a film that's all about a kid going somewhere and looking for something, this method of editing makes us feel the experience this young boy's having, even if we just don't think about it while we're watching it. So, how does a filmmaker make one lost child stand out in a crowd of hundreds? Apart from being who the camera and story focus on, the filmmaker doesn't make him stand out because they all shared the situation. So we feel for the issue that the kid is facing maybe more than the kid himself, so that anyone can really empathize in their own way. When thinking of the stakes at play in Lion, what are we thinking about? We already know through time interpolating cutting that our protagonist Saru survives and gets a nice family. So why is it that we are so emotionally attached to him as a child? It's not just because he's a child, and I wouldn't say the filmmakers are trying to tell us that he is special in any way, and that we should only care about him and his situation. Rather, the power I take from this film is that Saru is far from special. The emotions I felt at the end when he found his family were extremely bittersweet. I was happy Saru made it back to see his family, but I was missing something that was so much more important to me. All those other kids that we saw that didn't get that in their lives, who were lost and only lost. Saru is here to show us what we wish they could all have, and it's so sad to know so few of them get it. I care so much for Saru and Lion because he represents an issue so vast and powerful, and I care because he is a legitimate victim of this, and there's no attempt to make it seem like he deserves it any less than the other kids. He is one of them. And that is why I care so much about it. Yeah, so this was a lot shorter of a video. I'm going to try to keep these videos a lot shorter so that they're more entertaining. And I'm going to try to be posting one video a week. So if you go ahead and like and subscribe and stay tuned for the next video, that would be fantastic.